Happy Resurrection Sunday, everyone. This is an exciting day, a day when we celebrate the victory of our Lord Jesus from the death and the grave. He has risen. Have you ever wondered what took place on Resurrection Sunday? Join us as we look into what happened and what it means for us today. Well, let's have a time of worship right now.
Death could not keep you in the grave. You have overcome the world. You took all sin and shame away. You have overcome the world. You're coming back again one day. You will overcome the world. Overcome the world. On your throne of majesty, you have overcome the world. The enemy cowers at your feet. You have overcome the world. I know you're coming back for me. You will overcome the world. Overcome the world. King Jesus, you're victorious. All the heaven roars, you're glorious. You are Lord of all. We shout your name, Jesus. You are God. You forever reign.
Once a year, we celebrate this wonderful event about the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And we're so familiar with the pictures of Easter. Growing up, I saw an Easter tradition, which is so familiar with the Filipinos, called salubong. It is a ritual that reenacts the meeting of the risen Christ and His Mother Mary after His resurrection. It normally happens on the early dawn of Easter Sunday. Another picture that small children are familiar with during this time is what you call Easter egg, which is not really found in the Bible, but is so popular today because of the symbol of new life that it brings. But the gospel narrates the story when some women went to the tomb in order to bring the spices that they have prepared for the dead body of Jesus. And I wonder what they were feeling that day when they went to the tomb. They were mourning because their Lord and their Messiah was dead. For 3 years, they have followed Him and put their faith in Him, only to see Him die on the cross that Friday. And their faith and hope were dashed to pieces. The Messiah who promised life to the disciples was dead. As He was dying on the cross, He even said to these words, "It is finished." And what put the nail in the coffin was the fact that He was buried in a tomb with a giant stone sealing His body. And in their minds, this was the end game. But what a surprise that Sunday morning, when they saw the stone rolled away and when they went into the tomb, they did not find the body of Jesus. They only saw an empty tomb. And two angels in dazzling apparel, according to ESV, appeared before them. And the angels said to the women, and we see this in Luke chapter 24, verse 5 and 6. "Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen." So the women told the apostles what they saw, and Peter and John ran to the tomb, and they saw not only empty tomb, but also empty grave linen clothes. In fact, in verse 12, Peter, however, got up and ran to the tomb, and bending over, he saw the strips of linen lying by themselves. And he went away wondering what had happened. Kind of like this white linen cloth that I'm holding right now. You know, according to Matthew, the chief priests and the Pharisees were requesting some guards to be put beside the tomb because they were saying that the disciples might come and steal the body of Jesus and give out a false report. But if someone had stolen the body, they wouldn't have removed the burial clothes and even neatly folded them. You know, many tombs nowadays become famous because of the famous dead person inside those tombs. But the tomb of Jesus is different. It is known today because there was no body found in that tomb. He has resurrected indeed. He's no longer dead. He is alive. And many times we look at our situation as hopeless and a dead end. But the message of Easter is so different. And there are three quick thoughts I want to share to us, you know, about the empty tomb and the empty cross and the empty grave clothes. First thing is, it gives us freedom from the past. And you know, the grave clothes represent the past life that we used to live. I believe that the empty grave clothes represent the promise of a new life in Christ, that we no longer have to live enslaved to sin because Jesus already broke the power of sin over our lives. Our sins have been forgiven because of the perfect sacrifice of the Lamb of God who died on that cross. And as we put our faith in Jesus, He gives us a new nature. Indeed, the old is gone and the new has come. Not only are we freed from the past, but we're also given the power to live in the present. The empty grave clothes represent that we can be clothed with a new way to live. We're clothed with the righteousness of Christ. Colossians chapter 3 talks about this, about putting off the old self and putting on the new self, which is being renewed in knowledge after the image of its creator. You know, there's a putting away of the old and there's a putting on of the new. You know, for example, if you have just gone to the gym or maybe you've played basketball and your clothes have been soiled and you've sweated after an intense workout, what do? You take it off and you put on a new fresh outfit. We now have a new nature in Christ. We cannot claim to be Christians and still live in sin and compromise. We are overcomers because Jesus has overcome sin and death. We're more than conquerors in Christ. And because of the resurrection, we have a new sense of purpose. We're not just to go through this life in survival mode, but we're called by God to be fruitful and to be successful and even to be significant. And lastly, the resurrection gives us hope in the future. The problems and the difficulties that we face every day, they're temporary. And no matter how seemingly hopeless and dead our situation is, there's always a turnaround. And you might feel that your situation is maybe a Good Friday or a Black Saturday, but remember this, Sunday is coming. And we can look far beyond our situation and circumstances and see the light that is ahead of the tunnel. You know, in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, it says, "For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all." No matter what happens to you and the tragedy or the pain that you are going through right now, let me encourage you, never give up. God can restore things that have been lost. And even if things may not be fully restored according to our expectation, our eternity is secure. And that is where we put our hope. Our hope is not in the short term of the here and the now. Our hope is in the future. It's in our eternity. And the empty cross, the empty tomb, the empty grave clothes do not give empty promises. In fact, the opposite is true. Because of the resurrection, we can now avail of every spiritual blessing in Christ. We do not have to fear about what tomorrow may bring. And the reality is, there's a lot of uncertainties nowadays. But what is certain is this, our God is good. What is certain is this, our God loves us all. Resurrection tells us that even if our mortal bodies may fade and eventually die, yet someday we will all live again. And as I end this short devotional today, may our hearts be filled with faith in the finished work of Christ on the cross and our hope in the bright future that we have. You know, this future is the anchor of our souls, and we can go through this life with the full assurance that our Savior lives, that He's coming back for us someday, and we will live victorious lives.
No sickness can claim us. You're the one who has overcome the world. All disease defeated. You're the one who has overcome the world. All my chains. chains are broken. You're the one who has overcome the world. No darkness will triumph. You're the one who has overcome the world. No sickness can claim us. You're the one who has overcome the world. All this is defeated. You're the one who has overcome the world. All my chains are broken. You're the one who has overcome the world. No darkness will triumph. You're the one who has overcome the world. 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 In Jesus, you're victorious. All the heaven roars. You're victorious. All the heaven roars. You're glorious. You are Lord of all. We shout your name, Jesus. You are God. You forever.
Well, let's pray right now. Lord, we thank you for the beauty of the resurrection of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, that the cross is empty, the grave is empty, and the grave clothes are empty. And because of this, we have hope. Because of this, we have the power to live a new life. Because of this, we have a new sense of purpose. Father, I pray for those who are in need of hope, in need of help, even right now. May you remind them that Jesus is alive, that Jesus hears, and that Jesus cares. And no matter what problems we're facing right now, we thank you, Lord God, that there's a bright future that is awaiting us. Lord, I thank you for allowing us to encounter you in a fresh way. And for those who may have not known Jesus yet, I thank you that they will be known. They will be introduced to the Savior that we have. And I thank you, Lord God, that you are reaching out to them, even right now as we speak. Lord, may your grace abound for those who are in need. We thank you for this, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Well, thank you for joining our Holy Week Devo. And if you like this Devo, go ahead and share it. Always have a great day.